Let us pray. As we enter into this place, to the mystery of your presence, all around us and between us and within us, and we enter into songs and prayers, rituals, draw us closer to you, to remind us of who you are. We open the pages of Scripture to read these stories, to encounter the richness of a tradition, full of ambiguity and full of questions, and full of the clear promise of your love, steadfast through the ages. So be with us as we speak and listen, all of us as we hear you. As our minds wander in distraction and as they refocus, help us to find you. Pray in your name. Amen. The first reading today comes from 2 Samuel chapter 24. Beginning at verse 1, and I will read just a little further than is marked in the bulletin, verses 1 through 4. This is a story from late in the reign of King David, and it is a precursor to his purchase of the land on which the temple will be built. And it is a story of David at the height of his power stumbling. Listen for God's word. Again, the anger of the Lord was kindled against Israel, and he incited David against them, saying, "Go, count the people of Israel and Judah." So the king said to Joab and the commanders of the army who were with him, "Go through all the tribes of Israel from Dan to Beersheba, and take a census of the people so that I may know how many there are." Joab said to the king, "May the Lord your God increase the number of the people a hundredfold, while the eyes of my lord the king can still see it. But why does my lord the king want to do this?" The king's word prevailed against Joab and the commanders of the army. So Joab and the commanders of the army went out from the presence of the king to take a census of the people of Israel. Our second reading comes from 1 Chronicles chapter 21. This is the same story told in another book of the Bible. And scholars believe that the stories were written several centuries apart, probably on either end of the Babylonian exile. So the people of Israel have lived through much and have considered their faith in God much between the two tellings of these stories. Listen for this second telling, the story from the height of David's reign. Satan stood up against Israel and incited David to count the people of Israel. So David said to Joab and the commanders of the army, "Go number Israel from Beersheba to Dan and bring me a report, that I may know their number." Joab said, "May the Lord increase the number of his people a hundredfold. Are they not my lord the king, all of them my lord's servants? Why then should my lord require this? Why should he bring guilt on Israel?" The king's word prevailed against Joab. So Joab departed and went throughout all Israel and came back to Jerusalem. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I was a child asleep in my room, in my bedroom. And I remember distinctly, not yet a teenager, an old older child, waking up in the night and looking across my bed to the foot of the bed. And I remember seeing there at the foot of my bed a shadow. It was like a shadow inside a shadow. Gave me so much in that moment. The memory of that shadow inside a shadow is the best way I know to describe it. It's still very clear in my mind. I have no idea whether I was awake or asleep. I really don't know what I was seeing. But I remember it, and it scared me so much. And then my dad was there. He affirmed for me the presence of God, the presence of someone who loves me, who wanted to help me. And he also affirmed for me that no matter what I faced, I had a choice. I had a choice how to face it. These stories from 2 Samuel and 1 Chronicles are very difficult stories. I believe that the Bible is the Word of God and that it contains stories that speak to one another. The Bible doesn't just tell us what to do and what to think, but it challenges us to wrestle with God and stories of God, to go deep into the life of God so that we will be changed. And so that the world around us will be changed through us. Scripture is alive, and it speaks to itself just as it speaks to us. The people who wrote Scripture, in the inspiration of their writing, over centuries of writing and editing and compiling, until we have a book that we hold in our hands today, the people who wrote Scripture intentionally retain stories that speak to one another and seem even to contradict one another so that we would wrestle with the depths of who God is and who we are called to be with God. And this story of David and the census is a terribly difficult story. In the first telling of it, David, at the height of his reign, is incited by the anger of God to command a census. And later in the story, after he insists on the census, God punishes Israel for the census. God gives Israel three choices: a plague, or famine, to ask, first of all, what is God doing that God would incite David to do this and then punish Israel? And not just punish David, but the people of Israel. And what's wrong with the census anyway? It's very confusing. And yet there the story is. And it is the story that precedes, it immediately leads up to the purchase of the land on which the temple will be built. It is a sacred prelude to the most holy site in Israel. It's very strange. The problem with a census is a question mark in the commentaries and literature that try to interpret this passage. And it may be that this exposes Israel to some ritual risk, but more deeply, a census means one of a few things. You're counting people for a reason. And why would a king count the people? We've seen in other books of the Bible that sometimes it's